A warm good morning to all my dear lovely students. Welcome back to the EVS class. Today, that is 24th May 2021, we are going to continue with Chapter 12, Cities and Villages. And today we are going to do the workbook exercises. So, let us start the class. The learning outcome. At the end of today's class, students will develop a thorough knowledge of the chapter. So students, let us start doing the workbook exercises of chapter number 12, page 33. Question 1. Fill in the blanks. A. Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai and Kolkata are the four major cities of India. B. Cities have pakka houses. C. Cities have less space and are too crowded. Yes, children, cities are very crowded with minimum space. There are no open spaces, very less open spaces. And yes, cities are too crowded. D. There are a few schools and hospitals in the villages. E. Village is a small settlement of people. Then moving on to question number 2. Short the following as seen in the cities and the villages. So here we are having two columns, one for the villages, the other one for the cities. So here we are going to short the following as seen in the villages and in the cities. So in the column of the villages, we are going to write number 1, large open spaces. Number 2, old means of transport. Number 3, clean air and water. Whereas in the column of the cities, we will be writing number 1, big schools, number 2, overcrowded shops, and number 3, traffic jams. Moving on to question number 3, state whether the given statement are true, that is T, or false, for which we are going to write as F. Statement 1. Cities have less space and more people. Yes, it is true. The space is less, but the number of people living in the cities, dwelling in the cities, it is quite high. That is why cities are very populated. Number B. Question number 3. B. Villages have few schools and hospitals. True. As compared to the cities, the villages, they are having very few schools and hospitals. That means the healthcare facilities and even for the higher education, people from the villages, they have to come to the cities for better opportunities, for better treatment. Question 3, C. People of cities live in kaccha houses. False. So if we see the people in the cities, they are living in pakka houses. Then question number 3, D. Agriculture is the main occupation in villages. True. Because as we learned, 70% of the population of rural India, they are depending on agriculture for their livelihood. Moving on to page number 34. So here, question number 4. Draw and compare a scene from a village and a city. So here, this will be learner's response. So you are going to draw a scene for each village and a city, and then the scene should give a good comparison between the city life and the village life. Okay, so dear children, now moving on to question number 5. Answer the following questions. Question A. What are the problems faced by the people living in villages? So here I have pointed out 4 points. Number 1, roads are not good. So as we have studied, dilapidated conditions of the roads. Okay. Number 2, electricity supply is poor. Number 3, limited choices of schools. Number 4, colleges are not available. Then moving on to question 5B. Why are there more people living in cities? So here I have again written 4 points for that. Number 1, pakka houses to live in. 2, good schools and colleges. 3, good healthcare services. And number 4, modern means of transport to travel. Then moving on to question number 5C. What is the reason of pollution of air and water in the cities? The answer is, the reason of pollution of air and water in the cities are automobile exhaust. Okay, the gases, the harmful gases coming out from the automobiles, the vehicles. So that is automobile exhaust. Then the next is littered roads. Yes, people are dumping their garbages on the roads, on the drains. So they are littering the roads. Okay, then next is sewage or water waste. Okay, so directly the waste that are discharged from the households, the sewage system, they are directly getting this waste and they are linking it to the main water, the rivers. Okay, so likewise what happened, these are the main causes, the main reasons of pollution of air and water in the cities. Okay, moving on to the next question, that is HOTS, higher order thinking skills. So here question 6A, are all houses in villages kaccha houses? Find out. Yes, nowadays since villages are also having access to modern technologies, so all houses in villages are not kaccha houses nowadays. Okay, even in villages we will see that people are constructing their building pakka houses. All right, then question number 6B, how does the lifestyle of people living in the villages and cities differ from each other? Here the answer is, I have segregated village, yes, I have written, and then below you can see I have written about the cities. Okay, for the villages, life is very simple. People work in fields and they have very less facilities. Okay, whereas if we compare the same with that of the cities, what we find, the life of the people in the cities, it is very complex. Okay, they work in offices, and in the cities they have wide range of facilities, starting from better internet connections, better electricity supply, better modes of transportation. All right, so this is the comparison between how the cities and the villages, they differ from each other. Okay, now children, let us move on to the homework that you all are supposed to do it, and you are going to submit that in the Google Classroom. The homework for today is workbook page number 35, question number 7, which you are going to do in the workbook itself. All right, my dear children, so please do the work and take care of yourself. Stay safe, stay healthy. All right, my dear children, bye bye and have a good day ahead. Thank you.